What up, everybody? It's me, CPA Strength, Jonathan and Dorn, CPA, licensed CPA in the state of Florida, strongest CPA in the state of Florida. Well, I haven't put a video up in a while. My business took off a little bit, and I'm back. I wanted to go over pretty much my template for everything. The template is DC Adler. Now, I got a lot of comments and whatnot, and it was like, hey, you know, it could be Dade Clur, it could be this or that, you know, Washington DC debits credits, you know, it's however you can think of it is the best. So, and I don't think I really made it clear before that, you know, if you just know DC Adler, like this isn't really going to get you anywhere, but it's a start. So I like to separate DC because it's debit credit, and then I like to separate the aid because that's the debit sides, asset, draw, expense, and then LUR is the credit side, liability, equity, revenue. So, it's however you can remember that is what's going to help you in your studies. Now, I learned this, I learned DCA, LUR, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue, versus credit. I learned this, after I already had an accounting degree, and I really didn't know what I was doing. So when I was actually studying for the CPA exam, I found this on a different YouTube video, and just clicked in me. So every day I would study, and I would write this out every single day. Then after a while, after I memorized it so well, then I just put a line here, and then I just put the DC aid LUR. I just wrote that, not the whole word down. Eventually, that carried over to like my first accounting job, that I would write this down there, and even now when I'm just working on a piece of paper or whatever, I just pretty much put a line like this, and that way I kind of work on my debits and my credits. So yeah, what I would say for you to do is, because you know, wherever you find this, hopefully you're in your first accounting class and you're looking on YouTube like what to do, because I'm fucking lost and I don't understand anything the teacher is saying. So you know, every time you do homework, every time you go to your accounting class, for sure just write, you know, DCA debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue, with the credit DCA LUR. Just write this just like it is every single time you go in, and then you know, your first couple times you're not going to be able to remember exactly what it is. But I guarantee you, after doing it 10, 20, 100 times, 1,000 times, you will know this. So this is kind of the start of it, and what I do want to talk about a couple different things. So added under the draw, because I had some people ask, you know, what's a draw? I think, you know, a distribution, a withdrawal, an owner's personal expense is something to help you out to remember what a draw is. Oh, also, you know, I said put this on your put this on your paper, you know, on top of a scratch piece of paper every time you go into your accounting classes, or you do accounting homework, or you're doing bookkeeping. And you know, this right here, what I'm teaching you is a supplement. It's not gonna, you know, like this right here and what I give you is not gonna make you an accountant. What it will do, it will make your it will make your classes go a lot better. I got a comment from somebody that says, you know, I was always messing up what a debit is, what a credit is, and where things go, and this right here kind of concreted it out. So, but I also, you know, write down the positive, that's a positive side. Also, this revenue is minus expenses is the income statement, so that's all contained right here. Asset, liabilities, and equity. That's the balance sheet. And draw is basically the other side of equity. So this right here, when you start out doing your homework and whatnot, I would, and for your classes and you do problems, I would start out writing all this down. Now the first time, this is going to take you, I don't know, 5 minutes, and then you might have to look back and say, well, what does this even mean? You know, what does all this mean? So the first time, I take you, you know, 5 or 10 minutes to get it all down, and but as you go through, it'll just, as you keep on writing this down, it'll be ingrained in your brain, and you'll just write a line here maybe on your paper. But anyways, thanks for watching. If you liked it, get a like in there, leave a comment or whatever, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.